So we're here this morning up in North Yorkshire, in the racing town of Moulton, or just outside of Moulton, with Emily. Emily, tell me, how old are you? Where are you from?
I've just turned 24 and I'm from Manchester originally.
From Manchester, okay. And you work here now for Mr. Tim Easterby.
Yeah.
Obviously a family steeped in racing history, the Easterby family. What's it like working in a yard like this?
It's quite busy, but it's not bad. It's all right. Everybody gets on. So everybody has a laugh and it helps get the day go quicker.
Yeah, you've got quite a lot of horses here. You've just told me,
yeah.
About 100 or so,
yeah.
Dotted around between this yard and another yard and the stud. And
yeah.
Okay, so how long have you worked up here for?
I've only been here about a month. I started at the start of April.
Okay, and how are you finding it then? Is it, you've got to know all the horses in that time, have you?
I've got to know some of them, but they're always changing. They're always bringing in new ones, or some are going off to other yards and stuff.
Okay, so it's predominantly flat horses you've got here, I'm guessing. Yeah, okay, okie dokie. I've seen some 2-year-olds dancing past us here. They look quite lively. It's quite cold and windy today, isn't it? It's quite wintry, so making a bit jittery. So, so tell me about your horsey background. So you came through the National Horse Racing College in 2019,
yeah.
And graduated January 2020 from the foundation course. What did you do with horses prior to going on that course?
I started riding when I was about 6. I was working at a riding school. I started out for a while, but I've done horseball, cross-country, dressage, eventing, show jumping, pony games, beach rides. I've done pretty much everything there is to do.
Okay, so you had a good sort of strong equine background,
yeah.
Prior to the foundation course, just not a racing background.
Yeah.
So it was just a case of sort of converting your riding to the style of racing.
Yeah.
And okay, okie dokie. And your work placement was in Middleham, so still in North Yorkshire, just the other side of North Yorkshire,
yeah.
From here, Mickey Hammonds. How was that?
That was all right. Again, like I cracked on with everything, knew all the horses, got on with everyone, so it wasn't bad.
Okay, you were there for a few months, weren't you? And obviously COVID,
yeah.
Then sort of took over, and obviously you were then let go during the COVID period,
yeah.
When racing sort of stopped. But obviously you found your way now across to the other side of North Yorkshire,
yeah.
To Moulton, and to this yard. So, so you're doing your level 2 apprenticeship. How's that going?
It's going all right. I've done all my paperwork. I've just got the practical bit to fill in now.
Okay, and so you're roving through to Anna's here today.
Yeah.
So she's going to do that with you this morning. How are you feeling?
A bit nervous because I can't remember what I've done and what I haven't done in a while.
I'm sure it'll all come flow back to you,
yeah.
The minute you start. So most people prefer the practical side, don't they, to doing the theory side. But you've obviously, during the lockdown, you've cracked on with the qualification,
yeah.
And used your time very productively. So well done, Emily. So right, I'm going to let you crack on because I know you've got stables to muck out, horses to get on off the walker. The horses come back in now from being exercised. So we'll let you carry on. All the very best of luck and thank you for sharing your experiences with us.
Thank you.